C-141 carries the DSRV. Two more C-141s carry the support band, skirt and mother sub pylons, auxiliary equipment, and the DSRV crew. Now, it all comes together. Part of the mother sub's special equipment are TV cameras, which observe the DSRV when it's piggyback on the sub. Once loaded, the mother sub and DSRV head for the search area. On the surface, they proceed at speeds limited mainly by the sea state, or they may move at 15 knots submerged. Sonars are used to locate the dis-sub by watching for returns from the submarine's sail or hull. Directional listening hydrophones may be used to listen for sounds from the bottom submarine. When the sub is located, the mission moves into the rendezvous phase. In mating to the mother submarine, the various ballast systems are adjusted for a neutral attitude. The DSRV eases onto the pylons at near zero velocity. Then, it notifies the mother sub when the pylons and mating skirt have positive contact. Now, the rescuees are loaded on board. 24 rescuees are carried each trip. Normally, 6 trips evacuate a nuclear submarine. Separating is essentially the reverse of mating. Upon return to the mother sub, if the rescuees require decompression, the DSRV is mated athwartships to the forward hatch to offload rescuees into pressurized compartments, then moved to the aft hatch for replenishment. When the last rescuee is aboard the mother submarine, the mission begins the return phase, and all the support equipment is returned to rescue unit home.
Oh, no, there's room inside there. I think it just said they can bring 24 of them up at a time. Oh, yeah, that's, and I don't know how many guys are on and operating it. But I remember seeing a deal on the news when, you know, when that happened. And apparently they could have saved a whole bunch of them, if not that. And I, what was the name of it? The Kursk? Was that the name of it? I think it was called the Kursk. Was the one that went down that we did the rescue on. But I think they got the guys out of the engine room, but everybody else, you know, if the Russians had just let us go down and help them, they'd have probably got a whole bunch of. They are ugly. It's a, I don't know, it's a cross between like a porpoise and maybe a seal or a whale and a mandible. And it is ugly. And when the old sailors thought that they saw mermaids, that's what they saw. And if you ever see a picture of one, you would never understand how you thought they thought that was a mermaid. But they made drawings of it, you know, that it had a tail and it had the body of a woman on top. But I mean, to tell you, a mandible is just unbelievable. It is ugly.